you walked in the joint, I could see you were
Ratched. Mildred Ratched.
Mildred Ratched is based off of the main character from the novel and 1975 film One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest by Milos Forman.
Go ahead, sit down.
Ratched is a psychological thriller featuring themes of murder, torture and incest. It is set in a 1940s mental hospital where gruesome treatments are experimented with. For example, clinically ill patients suffering from lesbianism are treated by being boiled alive. The treatments are disturbing to watch, however the juxtaposition of the show's visually pleasing aesthetics creates a sense of unease. There is a lasting motif throughout the series. The colour green is present in almost every shot. There are so many factors of green that I cannot even explore them all. My main focus will be in regards to Nurse Ratched herself and the way that green encapsulates her sinful character. I will analyse this in relation to James McDowell's sense of the quirky and stylistic films of Wes Anderson. I will also look into how other colours in the series accentuate the use of green with regards to the most intense character of the series, Lenore Osgood. From the very first scene, viewers are compelled by the colour green, seen on the priest's stole. In the church, the green stole represents ordinary time, between Easter and Christmas. However, this particular night is somewhat out of the ordinary, because, spoiler alert, they all die. Notice the peculiar green hue coming from the outdoor lighting of the church, immediately forcing an eerie, unsettling vibe for the night. Then look at the vegetables on the dinner table. They are so vibrantly green that they cannot possibly be edible. In fact, they almost appear animated. But why is it that green in particular has to be so bold? Let's delve deeper into this colour palette, beginning with Ratched's first appearance in episode 1. Ratched's unmistakable turquoise car is an icon of the series. The red scarf, lipstick, gloves and embroidery is a bold contrast, reflecting Ratched's bold character.
You should bathe more often. Your fingernails are filthy.
The next outfit is so prominent that it has its own off-body sequence, including a shot where we see Ratched stealing the suit, highlighting a darker aspect of her personality. This outfit is striking because, for the majority of the series after this point, Ratched is seen mainly in the green nurse's uniform, but the striking opposing mustard suit indicates that she is different to the rest. In an interview with the costume designers Lou Irish and Rebecca Guzzi, Guzzi stated that Mildred had to be a visual force to reckon with, and she said that for all the colours that they looked at amongst the set, mustard yellow popped the most. The designers highlighted that they took inspiration from monochromatic colour combinations from Vogue through mid to late 40s. The suit dresses are all similar and stay true to the 40s silhouette of the strong shoulder and cinched waist, and women in dresses, always gloves, always hats, according to Irish. This Vogue monochromatic inspiration can be seen in the nurses' uniforms, which represents hierarchies as they all appear to be in a slightly different hue of green. This also includes Dr. Hanover. The uniforms have blue tones, appearing bright and pleasing to the eye. After all, they are nurses. However, other characters in the series appear to be in deeper and darker shades of green, such as the murderer, the victim of attack who is the rapist of the murderer's mother, and the hitman. This indicates that the characters with bad intentions wear a darker shade, and Ratched is only seen in the bright nurse's uniform because her job is her disguise, to free her imprisoned murderer of a brother. The variations of colour in Ratched are a stark contrast to the clinical white overload from the original One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Ratched has an intense stylistic appearance. The visuals are so bold and slick that it creates a cinematic viewing experience. The aesthetics are similar to the works by Wes Anderson, who is renowned for his distinctive style, so much so that he has been labelled the godfather of the quirky American indie. James McDowell's article explores this idea of the quirky, highlighting its attributes, feelings and tone, and in his words, is a visual style that courts a fastidious artificiality. Quirky films are peculiar, unexpected, and eccentric. They usually have a bizarre narrative, block repeated colours, childlike tendencies, and peculiar framing. Innocence is portrayed in an artistic description, which stimulates a delicate balance of sensibility. Thereby, if we remove One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest with Wes Anderson's The Grand Budapest Hotel, visual connections are made instantly. The block minimal colour palette is the most obvious similarity. Ratched is just a short 8-episode Netflix original series, adopting characteristics from the great Indiewood quirky cinema. Netflix is providing grounds for a new contemporary style of quality television.
But a disordered mind can't cure itself. That's why tomorrow is a big day for you. You'll finally be free.
However, Ratched does not feature the childlike or comedic attributes of the quirky. Opposingly, Ratched uses colour and framing to exaggerate the distressing tone. This becomes more perplex when we meet the most exuberant character of the series.
Hey, Miss Osgood. I hope I'm not disturbing you.
Not at all.
Lenore Osgood, the wealthy heiress, is one of the few main characters not to be seen in green on first appearance. In fact, Osgood happens to have the widest array of colours in her wardrobe. The outfits reflect her wealth and extravagant character. When we do not see Osgood dressed in green, she is enveloped in it by her lavish surroundings. Despite illustrating Lenore's flamboyancy, her intense emotions are interpreted through the colour of costume and set.
For jealousy, envy, greed, had a lot of definitions, so we would pepper it in when needed. So like when Sharon Stone shows up at the hotel in her green gown with the monkey in the green dress.
Lenore is seen in green on arrival to her business meeting with Mildred Ratched, where greed is coursing through her veins. The red accents illustrate her anger and bloodthirsty revenge as she longs for Mr. Hanover to be dead. The attention to detail, especially regarding the monkey's matching attire, creates appreciation but also truly describes the tone of each individual scene. Lenore wears pure whites and creams before we find out about the tragedy of her son, red when she finds out her hitman has been murdered, green when she is overcome with greed, black when she finds out she has been taken advantage of, and blue when she makes a business deal, and so on. This expresses the case that colour is telling. It speaks from the screen, to give understanding, to connect with, and to admire. The way that colours appear on screen is an art form that Ratched takes full advantage of. The use of the colour green is a constant metaphor of greed, envy, jealousy and rage, all lie as the foundation of the series' dark narrative, as well as being a visual pleasure for viewers. The tone-on-tone costumes by Lou Irish and Rebecca Guzzi are accentuated by the extravagant set design and peculiar lighting, which make up the effect of visual solace. The aesthetics of Ratched resonate with the aesthetics of the quirky, but with a contrasting dark narrative. When Ratched is placed side by side with Wes Anderson's The Grand Budapest Hotel, far more connections are made than with the original One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. When thinking of Ratched, the colour palette springs to mind as greens and blues appear, making the series easily recognisable. The visual aesthetics ultimately create a cinematic view and experience, the future for contemporary streaming.
Thank you for your time.
Did you ever?